Hello students, welcome back to the class. We'll continue this video further with the last exercise of the chapter, that is 3.7, which has few word problems in it. Okay, so let us go with that. Renu purchases 2 bags of fertilizer of weight 75 kg and 69 kg. Find the maximum value of the weight which can measure the weight of the fertilizer exact number of times. Children, now after reading the question, you will have a thought into your mind. Then how do we judge whether we have to go for HCF or LCM? The answer will be given to you in your question itself. But for that, you need one thought. Okay, the question asked to you is find the maximum value. The word maximum gives you an idea about highest common factor. Maximum means highest. Okay, the words like maximum, greatest, longest, all this targets you towards HCF. It is smallest, minimum, minimum, max, all this opposite words. Okay, as it will go with the question, I'll help you out. So here maximum, so we have to find HCF of 75 and 69. Okay, so here as usually we have listed out the prime factors we have found of 75 and 69 using the division method. The factors of prime factors of 75 we have 3 into 5 into 5, and 69 children we have 3 into 23 over here. Okay, so now what do we have a common number in it? That is only 3 children. So only 3 is common between the both. So you can see the common factor of 75 and 69 is 3. Hence the HCF will also be 3 only. So the required maximum value of the weight is nothing but 3 kg over here. Question number 2. 3 boys step off together from the same spot, means they are starting from the same place. Their steps measure 63 cm, 70 cm and 77 cm respectively. What is the minimum distance each should cover so that all can cover the distance in the complete step? So here they are talking about minimum distance. What I told you, pick up the word minimum. Minimum means they are going for LCM. That means all these 3 numbers we will find the LCM, that is 63, 70 and 77. So what are the prime factors of the 3? 2 into 3 into 3 into 5 into 7 into 11. When we multiply all of them, we get here our answer is 6930. Okay, so hence the required minimum distance is nothing but 6930 centimeter is the answer to our question number 2. Question number 6. The traffic lights at 3 different road crossing change after every 48 seconds, 72 seconds, 108 seconds respectively. If they change simultaneously at 7 a.m., at what time will they change simultaneously again? So all the 3 will change at what time, that we have to find here. So whenever you they are given such question that when they will go together, that means the least time they will take together to start off here. So we have to find their LCM. LCM of all the 3, that is 48, 72 and 108. The factors are 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3. Multiplying them all, we get here 432 seconds as our answer here. Still, if you want children, if you want, you can change it into minutes. Divide this by 60, you will get your answer here as 7 minutes and 12 seconds. So when the lights will change again simultaneously, in 7 minutes and 12 seconds after 7 a.m. Question number 8 here. Find the least number which when divided by 6, 15 and 18 leaves the remainder 5 in each cases. Okay, here they are asking find the least number. That means obviously it gives us idea that we have to find the LCM. So let us first find the LCM. LCM of 6, 15 and 18 children, you get here when you find the prime factors, you will get your LCM here as 90. Now, it is told to us in the question that that has remainder 5 in each case. That means that particular number remainder is 5. That means the it is here it is not there, but we have to still add 5 to it so that we have remainder 5. Otherwise, we cannot have remainder because here we it is exactly divisible shown. So, what we have to do? We have to add this 5 to the LCM. Okay. So, here S90 is the least number exactly divisible by the 3 numbers. So, to get a remainder 5, the least number will be 90 plus 5, that is equal to 95. Hence, the required number according to our question here is 95 over here. Now, question number 10, find the LCM of the following number. Children, here we have to find the LCM of 9 and 4. Okay, to find the LCM of 9 and 4, when we find, we will get the factors as 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. And when you multiply, you get 36. And what is the relation here? That is the product of 9 and 4. Here 2 you get here as 36. Similarly, 15 and 4, the LCM of 15 and 4 here, you have 2 into 2 into 3 into 5, which is equal to 60. Here also you will find, children, that the product of the given two numbers, that is 15 into 4, when you do, still you will get 60. So, that is the relationship between the LCM and its product given to you all here. So, with this, children, we end this chapter over here. Hope you understood the concept of HCF and LCM very well. Now, I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.